Find out every detail about the ISIN code for securities, its structure and usage. Have you ever noticed a unique code associated with every share, bond or security that you hold in your DMAT account? This code is called the ISIN code, which stands for International Securities Identification Number. This is a unique 12-character alphanumeric code that is used to identify securities world over. The numbers are allocated by a country's respective National Number Agency, NNA, governed by the International Organization for Standardization. It is used to number securities such as stocks, equity, and preference shares, bonds, options, and futures. The Securities and Exchange Board of India, that is SEBI, is authorized to issue the ISIN code to securities in India. Reserve Bank of India is authorized to issue the ISIN code. ISIN consists of three parts. The first is a two-letter country code. For instance, if we consider Reliance Industries, the ISIN code is INE002A0101-8, where first two alphabet letter IN is the country code for India, followed by nine digits that identify a specific security. The final character, also called a check digit, validates the ISIN code. This code is critical as it prevents counterfeit or forgery. Let us understand it a little better by decoding all characters in the ISIN code for Reliance Industries. We have already discussed the first two letters, which is the country code, IN for India. The next is the issuer type. In this case, the letter E stands for company. The following four characters, that is 002A, is used to identify the company, that is Reliance Industries. Every company is assigned a unique number that runs from 001A999F. In this case, the following two digits, that is 01, is used to identify the type of security like shares, mutual funds, bonds, etc. The next two digits, that are 01 in this example, are issued for serial order for each security. Finally, the check digit, 08 in this case, helps to validate the code. While a regular investor or trader may not have to pay much attention to this code, the ISIN code is useful during transactions where one needs to transfer shares from one DMAT to another, or in the case of dematerialization of physical certificates to electronic form. That's a wrap on all that you need to know about the ISIN code.
Investment in securities market are subject to market risks. Read all the related documents carefully before investing.